I often find myself thinking about the advantages and disadvantages of trying to travel down multiple paths rather than just one path. In other words, the pros and cons of specializing, having one pursuit, one goal, and being fixed on that, versus being a jack of all trades. I'm very lucky in that I get to intimately observe both approaches to creative work. At the moment, I'm working at the Royal Opera House, so every day I'm rehearsing with and brushing past artists who have reached the pinnacle of their specialist discipline. Principal dancers of the Royal Ballet, for example. Individuals who have reached the highest rank of the best ballet company in the world. But also prima donna singers, master pianists, conductors, directors, designers, choreographers, you name it. And when I speak to or do research on these individuals and trace their path, when and where they started, with whom they trained, how long they've been working on their specific craft, it's scary. These are extremely talented, disciplined, singular, hyper-specialized individuals. And speaking of extremely talented, disciplined, singular, and hyper-specialized individuals, leads me perfectly onto a birthday celebration. 15th of April, I want to see if you can guess who the birthday boy is. So I went to the National Gallery this afternoon to pay homage to him in room 9. That's your first clue. He was an anatomist who drew and catalogued the entire human body. He was an architect who designed grand cities and buildings that were revolutionary for his time. He was an astronomer who studied the night sky and created designs for one of the first telescopes. He was a botanist who examined and documented plants. He was a cartographer who created some of the first contemporary maps. He was an engineer who designed countless amazing machines and structures. He was a geologist who studied the Earth, discovering and theorizing the origins of fossils. He was a hydrodynamicist, dedicated to understanding the forces and flows of fluids. He was a mathematician who incorporated his calculations into the core of his art. He was a musician who played and taught instruments, even designing several of his own. He was a theatre producer who created immersive sets and props that blew audiences away. He was a scientist who theorized, tested, and discovered many new groundbreaking ideas. He was an inventor, pushing the boundaries of what was technologically possible at the time. He is perhaps the world's most famous artist. He was born just outside of Florence and turns 571 today. His name? Leonardo da Vinci. Happy birthday, Leonardo. It was lovely to see your Virgin of the Rocks at the National Gallery today. And thanks to you, I feel absolutely humbled and no longer feel sorry for myself. Sometimes I think, how is this all going to work? Trying to be a writer, dancer, actor, singer, director, producer, master of ceremonies, now filmmaker, editor, and tulip expert. But now I'm thinking it doesn't sound ambitious enough. Got to love the flower path.